Good evening on this eve of Good Friday. We pick up our study in Matthew's Gospel chapter 6. And last time we talked about how 12 different times Jesus says, in reference to God the Father, your heavenly Father. And we come to verses 7 and following. And as we read last time, when you pray, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do. For they think that they will be heard for their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask him. Pray then like this: Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. We pause our reading at that point, and I want to point out to you the fact that this is called oftentimes the Lord's Prayer. It is that, but it's also a prayer that he taught to his disciples. It's a great model for prayer, and it's probably a prayer that Jesus repeated many times in his own life, and in many occasions, perhaps with his people. We know that the beginning point is not a quick running off to ask God to meet our needs. Now, there are times in our life and seasons in our life when that is all that we can do, and that is entirely appropriate in the context of our relationship with our Heavenly Father. But you will note that the concern in this passage, in terms of prayer, are three things initially. Of course, our Father in heaven. We recognize that He is our Father in Christ. We recognize that He is seated in heaven, as we said last time. And then it says, hallowed be your name. Literally, let your name be kept holy. Or let your name be treated with reverence. Second thing we note is that he says, your kingdom come. It is the idea of the expansion of the kingdom of God, the expansion of the sphere of the rule of the Lord Jesus Christ here on earth. We recognize that it is an already, but it's a not yet. In other words, already God's kingdom is coming, but it has not yet come in its fullness. The fullness of God's kingdom comes at another time in history when Jesus Christ comes back and he brings about the new heavens and the new earth. So we have a sense of passion for God's glory. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. May the sphere of your ruling expand. And then your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. A cry that God's will actually be done here on earth. When we think about how God's will is done in heaven, as God speaks to the angels, there is no option for them. They don't have the option of disobedience. They don't exercise the option of disobedience. They fully obey God 100% of the time. Let's just look to the Lord in prayer and think about these three principles that begin what we know of as the Lord's Prayer. Would you pray with me? Gracious God, we come to you tonight asking that in our homes and in our own personal hearts and in our own minds that you would be sanctified and set apart as holy, that your kingdom would come and expand as we continue to learn and continue to submit to the Lordship of Christ in our lives. And in our lives, we pray that your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We know that we fall short in many ways, and we thank you for the righteousness of Christ on our behalf. Father, we pray that these things would take place as well as it relates to the communities of Kalkaska and Mansalona and South Boardman and the outlying communities that are represented in terms of our church family and anyone who may be listening anywhere, that there would be this great sense of passion in our communities for your name and for your reputation, for your glory, for the coming of your kingdom, and for the doing of your will, that it would be the case in the state of Michigan, that it would be the case in the United States of America and all the 50 states that are represented, that it would be the case in the world. And yet we know, Lord, that it will never truly be the case, that this prayer won't truly be realized until the Lord Jesus Christ comes back. And so as we face trying times and challenging things and anxious days, if we're not careful, we look to you and we cry out, even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus, and bring about your kingdom and your rule in its fullness. And we rejoice that we can come to you in prayer. Father, would you stamp upon our hearts this model of prayer so that our first passions would not be our needs, but our first passions would be your reputation, your glory, your kingdom, and your will being done. Thank you for this time together tonight. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. If you look on our website tomorrow, Lord willing, sometime during the day, I will be posting a devotional for Good Friday. And also look forward to Sunday together and another sermon. And I'll be speaking out of John chapter 11 and Jesus' resurrection of Lazarus. So look forward to that time with you as well. And I pray and hope and trust that you will have a good and godly evening. Good night.